Hello, guys. I'm over here by the turntable to show you a new purchase here, or actually an exchange. I had a Sumiko Parawood Celebration cartridge, which was great. And I was able to swap it out with the guy on Audio Gun for this puppy. If you can see it, see if we can get in there. Well, I don't know if you can see, but this is a Phasemation PP. No, it's not working. PP300. Phasemation makes, that I know of, a PP300 and a PP1000. The 1000 is the real super pricey one. This one is not cheap, but trying this out, I took off the Lyra. This is the Lyra. Where is it? The Lyra Scala. Somewhere. There it is. Took that off so I can try this out. And I must say, it is working wonderfully in my system. It's got a little more bass to it, some more warmth, which is what I needed because, you know, these speakers here are the Martin Logan's, very, very revealing. The system is a very revealing system. The preamp, the Sutherland that we talked about before in another video. So a little warmth and lushness brought to the proceedings is not hurting. To me, it's sounding just wonderful. I'm really digging it. So this might be a keeper. I mean, you know, you could probably hear a little bit of it right now, but just wanted to pick that out. And also an update on the cables. I did put those cables back in. I don't know if you can see, but cables I didn't think made a difference. The Audio Quest cables that I got, a little more pricey cable than the regular Blue Gene. I put them in and trying them out, breaking them in. Since I couldn't tell much of a difference other than that little bit of harshness, I figured, what the heck, put them in, try them out. And you can see the batteries on the southern one there. They have the lid off right now. 16D batteries. So anyway, everything sounds great. So I'm gonna keep these cables for now. I put them up for sale, but I haven't had any offers, so I'm you playing them, breaking them in, and see what happens. So let's talk about some records. What do we have? Let's turn this down a little bit. First up, a little Prague Caravan in the Land of Gray and Pink. Probably one of their best albums, I think widely regarded. I believe this is on London, yes. London. Great old advertising. This is really a terrific, I don't know if you'd call it like pastoral prog. I tend to like that kind of stuff. I believe this is part of the Canterbury scene. It included Robert Wyatt and Soft Machine. Richard and David Sinclair, both in this band. And one of my favorite names, Pye Hastings. That's not a British name. I don't know what the hell is. And Jimmy Hastings. So this is, you know, again, if you like prog and you don't know Caravan, this is probably the album to get. Some mothers may argue Girls That Go Plump in the Night is very good too, but let's start here. Classical. This is a very nice sounding record. It's a Phase 4 stereo, which are wonderful sounding records, also in London. This is a Strauss Don Juan. Very, you know, again, right in that turn of the century sweet spot that I like a lot. So this is very nice, and just a really wonderful, wonderful sounding record. If you see these Phase 4s, you should pick them up. Everyone I've heard has been great. By the way, what were we listening to? This is Grant Green. Grant Green's Green Street. I have several Grant Green albums. Guitarist, jazz guitarist. And every one of them is great. Idle Moments, Green Street, Oleo, Gooden's Corner. I don't know. You see an album by Grant Green from the 60s on Blue Note, just get it. You're not going to not like it. It's almost impossible. Here's a really interesting album that I was able to finally track down. This is a reissue. Been looking for this for years. I'll put it on the original label colors. Dr. John's The Night Tripper, Grigri. This is Dr. John in kind of like New Orleans psychedelic mode when he first started out. Great picture. No drugs involved there, presumably. And it is just like deep swamp psychedelia. Fan-frickin-tastic album. One of those, it's going to be in your collection. Nothing is going to sound like it. You know, just one of a kind. Really hit it out of the park with the kind of mood on this record. I love it. And this is a nice sounding reissue. It says it's on Atco. I assume that they put it out. I don't know exactly how this got released again, but this is the more recent one, and I recommend this. It's going to be hard to find a clean original copy for an affordable price, I think. Speaking of clean original copies, actually, where'd it go? Alright, well, this is one too. Gordon Lightfoot. Not Edmund Fitzgerald, Gordon Lightfoot. If you could read my mind, this is very nice. I've avoided getting any Gordon Lightfoot, because even though I know some of his songs and sort of generally sort of like them, I always thought he was kind of lame, and I never imagined him being much of an album artist. Turns out I was wrong. This is very good. Very enjoyable, and more interesting than I gave him credit for. Personnel, him on guitar, Red Shea on guitar, and Rick Haynes on bass. And it's just a very, like, stripped-down recording. Big songs on here is, well, If You Could Read My Mind, obviously that was a hit. And he does Me and Bobby McGee on here. With Bottleneck Guitar by Ry Cooder. Other people on here, String Arrangements by none other than Randy Newman. Who is a top five artist for me, probably. Randy. I'll get into Randy Newman some other day. But he's just one of the greatest. And John Sebastian plays a couple auto harp, harmonica. Van Dyke Parks on harmonium. Pretty illustrious little set of collection of musicians here. So this is really good. Gotta recommend it. Here's some I picked up my local record store, Reimagined Records, New Hartford, New York. Just came into a jazz collection, and I was able to pick up a whole bunch of records from them. But I'll pick out some of the highlights here. the biggest highlight is this puppy. Miles Davis Sketches of Spain on 6-Eye Columbia Mono. Wow! Oh, I saw this. I almost, you know, spit up my lunch. This is one of my favorite albums, you know, period. One of Miles' greatest albums. Again, unlike any other Miles album. But this with the strings, orchestra by Gil Evans, arranged by Gil Evans. And it's just fantastic. If you don't have this, I mean, and you're at all interested in human beings, you should have this. It's just that great. And, you know, I have this on stereo. I have a 2-Eye, Columbia 2-Eye, which is probably, you know, early 60s reissue. Which sounds wonderful as well. It's a little bright, but not in a offensive way. It's really crystal clear. This one being in mono, that's stereo. This one is in mono. And this one, the horn just pops right out in front. In a way that I don't think it does in the stereo. So this sounds fantastic, and this is just a treasure for me to have. While we're on the Miles subject, this was another one I picked up. Someday My Prince Will Come. Now, again, 6-Eye. I thought that the original cover of this was his wife. Was it Frances Davis, or was on the boat? There's an alternative cover to this, and I thought that was the original. But I saw this, and it's on 6-Eye Columbia. Again, mono. So I'm a little bit confused, because 6-Eye only goes into the early 60s. Like, I don't know what. 60, 61 they stopped doing that? I don't remember, but... And this album is about from 60, 59, 60. It's right around that time, so... I don't really understand what's going on here. I need to research. Someone probably knows. Maybe you can comment down in the comment section what the deal with this cover is. But, again, you know, Coltrane's on here, which is nice. This is kind of like the Kind of Blue band doing some other stuff. And this is great, too, you know. Here's another one. Jesus. Another just fantastic record, which you can't go wrong. Owning Waltz for Debbie by Bill Evans Trio. This is the trio with Scott LaFaro on bass, who's unbelievable. Paul Motion on drums. Scott LaFaro died shortly after this record came out, I think. He only made a few records with Scott LaFaro. He died tragically. Soon after, and it was replaced by Chuck Israels, I think. This is from 61, Live at the Village Vanguard. One of the more romantic albums you're gonna ever hear. I'm sure most of you know it, but if you don't, again, very essential. So, again, I'm not sure if this is, you know, it's on Blue Riverside. I picked it up because, I mean, I have this, obviously, but I have it in a reissue. I picked this up because I thought it was a pretty good chance that this was a first pressing. I'm not sure, though. It is mono, but I don't know. I gotta investigate that, too. And then I heard This Is Good. I've never heard it. I don't have it. It's also Scott LaFaro on bass, Bill Evans Explorations. So, this is on Green Riverside. I don't know what to make of it. Again, mono. This guy's collection was entirely mono, almost, which is sort of strange, but, you know, wonderful sounding records so far. I got a bunch of other stuff, too, but this is just some of the highlights. And I think that's it for today. So, until next time, take it easy.